Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is GearChain 6. GearChain 6 is called GearChain 6 because of the gears that have 6 teeth. You have may seen an earlier prototype of this puzzle that looks similar, but it has gears with 12 teeth. I didn't like that design that much, so now I went for the 6 teeth, and I made two versions. This one has 19 gears, and this one has 16. So let me start with the one with 16. That's an even number, and it's relatively easy to make shapes. Here you see all of them in a line, and I'm going to fold them into a square. And there we are. I've folded it in a square. It's a bit dexterity and a looking around, but since it's an even number of gears, it's not extremely difficult because it does not depend how you start exactly. At the end, things will always work out. However, that's different from the one with 19 gears that I'm going to fold into a hexagon. Actually, I don't know how to do this, so I'm going to use the screwdriver solution, and I'm just going to disconnect here one gear. This gives you a good opportunity to see how this is constructed. Just some simple yellow links, a gear with a little screw, and that's it. So let me start and fold this and see how I can make a hexagon. So it already starts looking like a hexagon, and now the only thing that I need to do is to connect the last little screw with gear, put them on top here, connect the screw, and okay, I've now done a sort of an illegal solution, but you see it is now a hexagon, and the interesting thing is that I can scramble it very easily. I can just take it apart and, well, we can roll the video in reverse to see how to put it back together again. But turning the video in reverse is like cheating, and to have it as an actual puzzle without the screwdriver solution is extremely difficult. I would not know how to exactly turn this into a hexagon without the screwdriver solution, so it's challenging. So here we have the beginner version, or let's call it the advanced version, and here we have the expert version, and the main difference is the number of gears. So my question to you is about the marketable potential of this puzzle. I think it could be marketed, but how would you market it? Thank you for watching.